今天因为我们这个早上要佛像、装帧啊等等的关系啊，时间晚了一些啊。
We start a bit early today because that we installed we did the installation ceremony this morning. So as you might see that we have this Buddha's installed.
但是也今天也很这个地方呢，就是有很多的刚刚来的各系们，大家一起念这个修法。加持了，今天这个地方是充满加持的力量。
But what is also extraordinary today is that, some other monks are invited to do the service, and so that bring all blessings for this place.
哎呀，那今天我们所要讲的这个课程呢、我们正在进行的普贤上师演讲。
So we are currently taking the words of my perfect teacher.
普贤上师演讲的今天呢，这个沟通外前行的部分。
Currently, what we're doing now is the extra preliminary practice.
它有六个，里面再有这个分六个，第一个就是下蛮难的部分。
So in this part, we are going to cover six points. And the first one is called, the difficulty, the difficulty of finding the freedoms and advantages. That is the first part, the first chapter.
Okay, 这个下面难得的第一个就是叫也叫思维本心无暇，这个叫什么？本心闲暇。
And the first part in this field is called reflecting on the nature of freedom.
这已经讲过了。
And we have already covered this one last time.
今天是思维特法圆满的部分。
And today we are going to start from reflecting on the particular advantages related to Dharma, which is on page 21.
这里的思维跟观想跟 meditation 其实是一样的。
Here the word reflecting actually means to visualize, to meditate.
因为有一种观想，有一种禅修呢，就是它没有什么对境的，就是心已经放下思维的一种状态。
There is a kind of meditation in which there is no an object so that you could do your meditation.
但有一种呢，就是你某一个特定的，就是一个对象，然后当作你的思维的对象，这就是一种禅修。
In other case, there is an object.
从那里呢？你继续。
There is another case that in the meditation you have an object, so that you could visualize the object in order to do your meditation.
所以这里呢，思维人生难得思维什么什么的时候，就是一种修思维，就是一种观修。
So here reflecting, we can just understand it or regard it as something like visualize or meditate.
而且也是观想。
It's actually just meditation.
在这方面就是我昨天看到那个南华经老师的一个书。
Yesterday I read a book which was written by a famous scholar, Buddhist scholar. 他是
他跟那个另外一个外国人一起的名义的那个名字我不知道是。
So anyway, he's a Chinese scholar, and he writes something about Buddhism.
Yeah, yeah. 有一个外国人问他说，什么是观想？我不懂观想。
That book is about a conversation between the scholar and a Westerner. So the Westerner, his Western friend asked him, what do you mean by meditation?
南华经老师说，是的，你很特别的在意，就是那种观想这个东西当作一件特别的东西，所以就观想不出来了。
So, and the scholar answers that,you took it too seriously and you think that there's definitely something that you have to put as the object of your meditation and that's why you cannot do your meditation successfully.
他说，那你现在像，如果我跟你开始谈你关于你的女朋友的事情、你会想得起来吗？
And so he said, if I put it another way, if I want you to think something about your girlfriend, so you know what you are going to think about.
他说 yeah, 就是一讲就是他的这个画面就出来了。
And so in this sense, he said, yeah, of course, and then he begins to visualize the situation.
南华经老师说，他说这就是观想。
And so the scholar just told him, this is meditation.
他那个时候应用了60大雷的一个轻舌。
Yeah, and so he quoted, one of the love poem of the 6th Dalai Lama.
的确，这次的喇嘛的那个一个经叫做“心把的懒中住，当比去了松那，才是立起你了，上几头不人都过死。”意思是说。我的心能够专注在那次个如此的这个心能够专注于道上，我确定可以能够获得极深成就。他是这样的，就是那个时候的词，就是他的那个亲人啊，这是亲人，我能够像念亲人这样的，能够像念，就是一年当中容易那种这种。一直一年当中就能够像起亲人一样的能够相应这个佛法的话，我保证可以获得极深成就。当然是这样说。
Okay, so His Holiness the Sixth Dalai Lama, in his poem, he writes that, if I could do the meditation in the same way I meditate my lover, then.I could just attain enlightenment. I mean, means that when he practices the Dharma, if he does the same way as that he meditate his girlfriend, then he could achieve anything in this Dharma field.
六十大利喇嘛的亲格有很多的解释，但是南华经的老师的解释就是也是完全以佛法的角度解释的。
Many people tried interpret the Sixth Dalai Lama's poems. Well, this scholar also did it, and also he did it from the Buddhist view.
南华经你知道吗？
我知道，我还
就是那个老师，
我知道。
OK， 好，应该就是还是用这个名字一下，就是中国很有名的那个，他就是一个近代的一个佛家吧，就是。
Okay.So this scholar, his name is 南华经. He's quite famous in China and in the Chinese culture.
那他的意思是说，第六世又有亲那个谈恋爱的经验，又想过他的亲人，又想过佛法。他说他用这两个对比，他觉得就是像观想佛法，就是你观想亲人是一样的意思。
Because the
一样的心态或者状态、啊。
Yeah, because the Sixth Dalai Lama had both experiences of falling in love, as well as practicing the Dharma. So he could make the comparison and to see the common point. It's actually the same when you levitate in Dharma field. It's exactly the same way when you visualize your lover.
所以我为什么讲这个故事呢？这里一直讲到四位死位的时候，主要是我们所学的这个内容上，你要深入的去思考，你专门安排一个时间思考这个人生难得，这叫做修人生难得。
So why
也叫做四位人生难得。
Okay, why I just took this example? Because we are talking about reflecting on the particular advantages.So we have to just practice to reflect the particular advantages related to the human life and related to Dharma.
Yeah. Yeah. 我想，那这种时候，比如说你很思念妈妈、思念家人的时候，我们没有不需要什么观不观想，就是你的一年就是当中就有这些画面出来。
When we miss our mother, and we just very spontaneously that the image is there. So we do not have to do it for some special purposely.
那我们今天呢，四位这个第一个四位的已经内容已经讲完了。今天我们要讲四位特法圆满，对吧？
Yeah.So last time we already talked about reflecting on the nature of freedom, and today we're going to talk about reflecting on particular advantages related to Dharma.
而且这个下满人生这个呢，并不是什么密宗特别的一个说法，这是整个佛法都有这个讲法。所以呢，我们那个时候要记得什么是就是八下十满。总共有十八个，所以就是八下十满。八下已经讲完了，那今天我们要讲十满，十个圆满。
Yeah. So it is said that we have eight opportunities, or eight freedoms, and also 10 perfections. So what we're going to talk about today is 是 So we finished the eight freedoms last time.And so today, what we're going to talk about is the 10 perfections.
这个是圆满的，也有一个叫做五种自圆满跟五种他圆满。
And these 10 perfections, put it in other words, it's 10 advantages. So there are five individual advantages and five substantial advantages.
今天要讲第一部分。
So probably today we just look at the five individual advantages.
So, 那就是叫所以圆满，幻境圆满，什么？
更得
圆满，意乐圆满，心性圆满。
It's just the very first short verses here. Okay. On page 22.
中文的话呢？
中文的话是，我们就去找一
个。我们都不一样的，你我的也不一样。
新书是四十二页。
是不是？
新书四十二页。
OK， 四十二页。
啊，也四十二页，对。
那就知道了。好，如龙树菩萨说，我现在要念啊，
他说什么 ？We move a little bit on.Onwards, downwards, yeah.
Yeah, 他知道了。如龙树菩萨说，是得生人种根具足，乐业即无道，心佛法。就龙树菩萨说，就这三个四个这里面的得生人种是怎么解释呢？你活的。不是得到就是所有的，但是呢，生就是你生为人，你生于中土，就是有这两个，要分开始。中土这些是在后面有，生就是出生者生，你就已经生为人，第一个条件。第二个呢，你生于在有佛法的地方叫做中，所以就是得生人种就是这样。 然后就是更居住，就是然后呢就是业绩无道，这是第四个，然后新佛法，这是第五个，谈到了啊。
So it's just the very first part in, on this page. There were five advantages mentioned. The first one is born a human and then in the central place and then with all one's faculties. Fourthly is without a conflicting lifestyle. And lastly was with faith in the Dharma.
如龙树菩萨说的哦不是不是啊，如为何的人生我现在不解释了，我要继续念。若为何的人生就不能止于佛法，而如今亦得下满人生。然后呢，所以这就故所以圆满，这就是我们的所以圆满。如果生于无有真法的边壁地方，则不能止于真法；而如今生于佛法兴盛的中途，故就是因为呢，就是环境圆满了。不具足诸根，不齐全那种有问题的话，就将成为修法的障碍。比如说你是一个瞎子，就是这样的话。而如今无有之类的孤患，故更得圆满。如果业绩跌倒，颠倒嘛，这个念，跌倒，则经常性不善业，未必正法。而如今呢，对善法生起心戒，所以亦能圆满。如果对心性的对境，就是佛法，不生起心性的话，则亦是不能取入正法，就是你不会去学习佛法。而如今呢，自己自心已取入佛真法，所以心性圆满。至无中圆满是观待自己方面应该具足的因此成为无中则圆满。这个里面的我想讲的是那种那我就不要讲了啊，就是不要讲，因为这个一些业绩跌倒啊，一些几个终点呢，后面有说明。你继续看，如果如果有特别的觉得不懂的地方，就举手问。
I do not want to have more words here because all the sentences and all the points get further explained in the latter part. So if you have any questions.Just let me know. Otherwise, I will just move on.
我就继续看了。所以圆满是什么呢？等一下啊。第一个是所以圆满的。要刚刚说我们是身为人是所以圆满，所以现在要进一步的解释呢，说所以圆满，要想修持真实正法，必定必定需要获得人生。这个比较有时候是觉得难理解的，但是这个有一个后面有一个说明。
So this what Khenpo just really is to practice the real authentic Dharma, it is absolutely necessary to be a human being. So for this part also there's some further explanation in the afterwards.
前几天啊，在台湾、印度、美国的一个我的朋友一个仁波切，他说他在西方江福兴上次演讲呢，要从后面的开始讲，不能从一开始讲。他说有些像是那个轮回过患呐、啊，一些西方人不愿意听， 所以只好就是从菩提心啊这些开始讲。我说我没有了，我就从头开始闭着眼，就是这样讲下去，不知道他们有没有接受。
Okay, so people just said that we had a chat with his Rinpoche friend who's teaching Dharma in the States. And his friend told him that he, instead of starting from the very beginning of the book, so this is the same book, but the other Rinpoche started from the very back of the word, of the book, because he said that the Westerners, it's not easy for the Westerners to take it seriously or to understand.
不像那种很悲观的这个轮回痛苦的那个部分。
Samsara part, because it's very pessimistic. So they would prefer to start from bodhicitta. So that's why the other Rinpoche just started from bodhicitta, how to generate bodhicitta. However, Khenpo said that I don't know, but I just start from the very beginning. I just follow the book, and I have no idea what people think about that. You could just follow the book, or you were there.
We are telling him when you finish the book, or just
I think the approach is different. One's where you show them some of the negative aspects.
That's true.
So what's better? That's his question.
That's not the question.
He follows the book.
Yeah. It's good. Yeah. Yeah, it's good. Yeah. 他就说他们就是不喜欢从那个悲观的负面的东西，他们喜欢传统比较正面积极的。没错。So you have very good faculties.
是的啦，其实是说《金刚经》里面说，听到声声或者比较广大的这个教言，不升起那种排斥的那种心呢、啊，等于是你的根基是成熟的。
According to the Diamond Sutra, when somebody is listening.The extraordinary teaching, Dharma teaching, well, they won't have any rejections, then that indicates they have very, very good faculties.
但是
The spot.
但是呢，一个也有一个是，因为是无感，所以没有反感。一个是比较认真的思考，还是没有反感。第二个是好的，第一个是还是不好的。
So,In two ways that people may not reject. The first one is if somebody is consciousless. So without any conscious, without any knowing or understanding or comprehension. So, and then they do not reject. And this is not the thing that he mentions. He mentions the other way that when you comprehend everything and still you do not reject it, you just accept it, that this is indication of a good faculty.
OK, 就是听到空心智慧不畏那种意思是说就是你深入思考这个空心的问题但是还是对空心很有兴趣那就真的是好事。
Let's take Shunyata for example. So if after very profound thinking and reflecting of emptiness,Still, you think it's reasonable and you still would like to accept this idea, and this is indicating of being in good faculty.
这里的所以圆满就是所以的概念，大家知道吗？中文本身的 OK， 所以这里呢说依靠跟所以是相对的，所以这里呢。就是像他的所依靠的对象叫所依，所以呢，人生不是修行的所依是什么呢？就是人生。OK， 比如说所依有什么定，就是这个桌子呢是什么呢？我的电脑现在所放的地方也是一种所依。
OK， So, Khenpo now talks about. Khenpo now talks about. The advantage of support. So, what do we mean by support? By support, it refers to the thing that give us support, provide support, like like the table, it provides the support for my computer, and like our human life provides the support for our practicing of Dharma.
Yeah. So okay, 我要想修持真正的正法。 必定需要获得人生，若未获得人生，虽然三恶趣中的最好的是蓬生，但尽管现在人间现实美妙，价值昂贵的蓬生，但无论被认为多么的好的，可是你对他说，现在如果你念一遍我玛尼本命吽，便可成佛。 然而他极听不懂心咒的词句，又不了之意，更不会讲话，甚至现在动时也只能低调忍受，而不知道想任何其他方法了。若是一个人呢，无论多么脆弱，起码他也知道去岩洞或树下。 建材生活、烤火取暖，但是旁生却连这种本能也没有。更何况说思维修法呢？天人等虽然身体极为神妙，但是也却不能成为趋向别解脱界的法器，所以七相学也。 不具有获得圆满佛法的容器。OK， 我这里要说明几个重点。一个呢，是不是停人跟旁生都真的完全不能修，不能有修行的机会？也不是。So
here I'd like to point out something. The first thing I'd like to point out is the question. Is it true that animal, either the animal or the gods of and other beings, do not have the chance to practice Dharma. The answer should be no.
比如说，释迦牟尼佛传第一次传法的时候的弟子里面，很多也是天人。For
example, for the first time when Shakyamuni Buddha, teaching the Dharma. There were some of his students were the gods.
但是，这是一个相对来说，人生是最圆满的所依，最好的所依。But
comparatively, human beings are the best form of practicing and listening, learning and practicing Dharma.
那动物也有一些有时候保护自己的本能，的确是有。 但是相对没有人这么好聪明。And
in terms of protecting or looking for a shelter, the animals do, they are capable of doing so, but comparatively again, they are less capable than human beings.
比如说这里特别说，具象别解脱界的法器是人。 这是佛法的说具象别解脱界的，什么叫具象呢？就是足够条件或者具足条件叫做具象。This
part in English version is quite clear, which is meet the requirements laid down for taking the pratimoksha vows.
具象别解脱，然后呢？ 那别解脱是什么概念呢？ 这个很重要。
What do we mean by practical pratimoksha? This is a very important concept.
到时候期末考里面也会有，开玩笑。
Because Khenpo had set up a curriculum, teaching curriculum. So according to the curriculum, there will be quiz and term exams. So he was just joking that it will be part of the exams.
佛教有三个戒，一个就是菩萨菩提，大家知道一般的这个，居士啊、出家啊那些戒，第一个是这种戒，第二个就是菩萨戒，第三个叫萨玛耶戒。
So there are three vows. The first vow is called Prati.Moksha vote. And this is for the practitioners.
This Bhakti Moksha, 就是遍解脱戒是所有佛教的基础，共同的基础的戒。
And Prati Moksha, okay, is the fundamental and it's common among all the Buddhist practitioners.
但菩萨戒呢，就是大乘的，就是戒。
And the second vow is called Bodhisattva vow, and which belong to the Mahayana school.
萨玛耶戒就是金刚乘的戒。
And the third vow is called Samaya vow, which belongs to Vajrayana.
那这个。那我现在关键是怎样的，如果 你是一个居士，你有受在家就是居士戒，或者你是一个出家人有受出家戒，你有受戒没有错，但是你受的戒是不是被解脱戒不一定。
So no matter you are a practitioner at home or you are a monk, and if you take some vowsthose vows, Prati Moksha,
yeah.
Moksha vows.
对，我们藏文写 Moksha， 就是藏文的发音，梵文的发音有时候不正确嘛。反正就是那个五百年一直用藏文写下来的，就是我们念 Moksha，
okay.
但是有时候可能是 Moksha， 因为梵文里面的 sha、ka、cha 有时候是这种。有点像破音字这样的一个概念，所以比较复杂，没关系，你怎么念就可以。
Okay, so it's just an explanation of how do we read it. It's Prati Moksha or Prati Moksha or Prati Moksha. So all these are just translated from
Moksha.
Moksha.
Okay, Moksha.
Moksha is Tibetan.
No.
Moksha is Tibetan.
Yeah.
Yeah.So Moksha is Tibetan, but Moksha is Sanskrit, and Moksha is English. I'm sorry.
No. Okay. Moksha. Yeah. 然后呢，就是我的意思，就是说一个人呢，就是比如说今天我们去那个南天寺，你就是受了什么戒回来了，但是你的戒是不是菩萨戒？也不是，也是不是？当然受菩萨戒就是菩萨戒，但是一般的戒不一定是菩萨戒，也不是金刚戒，那是不是别解脱戒？也不一定。
So,
这就是关键的思考。
For example, if you just visit a Nanting temple today, and you took some vows there, and were they Bodhisattva vow? No. And were they Vajrasattva vow? No.But does it mean that it definitely is a plucky moksha vow? It is not necessarily.
那这是什么意思呢？如果你受戒的目的不是为了解脱，那就是不是别解脱戒。
So if the purpose that you take the vow is not to get the enlightenment, not to get the liberation, then that is not a Prati Moksha vow.
Yeah, 这里的 Prati Moksha, Prati 就是别的意思， Moksha 是 解脱的意思。所以呢，别解脱就是分别与解脱，啊，就是分别与轮回，与轮回分别出来，就是解脱了，就是从这个轮回别解脱，就是这分别的，然后就是解脱了，所以叫别解脱解。这种呢，就是你现在呢，你现在当然还没有别解脱了，但是你至少你的动机有出离心，那就是这是个结，就是别解脱解。
So actually, it just look at the purpose of taking the vow. So this vow, the moksha vow, actually means to cut off the from the
分开的那种感觉。
Yeah, to separate from the samsara.
Yeah, 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 good.
To cut out
individual liberation.
Yeah,
that's in here.
Yeah.
Individual liberation.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Just that you do not think about the samsara.
有这个有故事的，就是释迦牟尼佛的弟弟标迪吧，然后就是劝他就是出家嘛，佛陀。他一开始一直不愿意，后来呢，佛陀用他的这个，神通力量，然后就是让他看到，天堂的一些，非常好的待遇，然后就是有一个无量站里面就是有很多的无间界的那个识别，然后这里面就只有那个天女，没有男生，然后呢就是，他问说，哎，这里到底是将来是谁？他说：“哎，那个这个在人间的那个佛陀的标的，如果他，今生他受戒的话呢，下一世就是能够做天人，就会来到这里。我们要照顾他。他觉得这里的天人天女都比我的那个，太太就是更加的美丽。他觉得值得受戒，所以就开始受戒了。
There is a story about this vow.” It says that Shakyamuni's cousin once would like to take vows, but so if he take the vow, and then he will enter a place where it's like just like heaven, where there is a lot of beautiful ladies without any male, and all the ladies there are much more beautiful than his wife. So he thought, okay, that's a good idea. So I would like to take vow. Well,
他后来出家了
But and then Buddha just told other people, okay, so this is my cousin, and he would like to take vow in order to get to this area where there are so many beautiful ladies.So do not help him. Yeah.
后来出家了，但是呢，佛陀说跟阿难尊者啊，他们说你不要跟他好了，他出家的目的不是解脱，你们出家的是解脱，所以你们的这种你们就是不同路的人了，所以就是你不要跟他讲话，就是严格的这样。然后呢，就是后来他也难过。然后后来又佛陀用另一个方式让他明白，其实天堂的幸福也最后还是会衰落的一个结束结尾，就是这个结果。所以就他后来真的又开始就是重新说了别解脱解，有这个故事。
Shakyamuni Buddha just told Ananda that do not make friends with him because his motivation was not to get liberation, and his motivation is something different. so when he became the monk, just Buddha Shakyamuni told Ananda so. And but finally, when his cousin gradually realized the situation, and finally he changed his nature.And he realized that even in the heaven, the final destination is 就是天堂最后的结果也不是解脱。
对，是佛陀让他知道 不是解脱，就是最后还是会这种离开这边嘛，就是会痛苦嘛，最后还是痛苦，所以就他回来成，就是那个罢了，就受了被解脱戒。
So, Shakyamuni Buddha just wants to teach him to know that, even in heaven, the final result is still suffering. So, finally, when he realized it, and he learned it, and finally he took this vow, the
其实这种受被解脱戒不是要重新受，只是你的动机就改善了，就变成你的戒就变成缘，就是被解脱戒。
So if you change your motivation and your attitude, then you take the practice mokcha vows.
现在明白了嘛？这个被解脱戒。但是呢，阿毗达摩跟律仪里面呢非常清楚的说，受真正的受被解脱戒的这个就是那个能出家的啊，能与那个居士的真正的这个身份是人，基本的条件是人，没有一个天人的身份的出家人，假设来说就是没有的，所以就是。这里强调的也是说，要受圆满的佛陀的教义呢，就是有就是人是最重要、最圆满的。
Okay, so according to Abhidhamma, to take a precept or to take vows, the best form is still the human being. So in order to get the perfection, those gods.May have the chance, but the perfect form is human being.
为什么呢？因为天人相守的太就是幸福了，所以呢不适合受戒，因为他没有这个动力很差，他对那种痛苦的体会非常差。
The reason is that being gods in heavens, they do not really experience sufferings, so they do not have the motivation to take the vows.
那畜生啊，恶鬼啊，这些就是因为他的痛苦太多，所以又没有就是没有机会，这个修行。
Animals or the hungry ghost, because they suffer too much.So they still have no chance to practice Dhamma.
而且人是刚刚好，尤其是因为呢，我们有这个有不是有很多的这个痛苦的那种机会，所以这个对修行来讲的话，有时候是好事嘛。
So a human being is just the perfect form because we do have sufferings, but not too much.
所以就是说，所以佛陀就是对天人跟其他的众生没有开放这个受戒。
So that's why, Buddha, he doesn't
开放这个自己，
he doesn't give the opportunities for other forms or the in other realms the opportunity to take the vows.
但是我们真的很爱修习的话呢，比如说一些大乘的。特别的一些经典跟金刚乘里面的有些部分的说法是不一样，但我们今天不讨论这些这么复杂的。
There may be some different explanations in Mahayana or Vajrayana literatures. Maybe that there are some different explanations, but we're not going to talk about that much today.
所以气相许。不具哦，不是，我们现在幻境圆满了啊，就是不错。所谓的中途可分为地界中途和佛法中途。你这个 highlight， 开玩笑，就是要特别注意一下这个地界中途跟这个佛法中途。
Could you just highlight the two words? One is central.So the central region, one is geographical central region, the other one is the central region in Dhamma sense.
低阶中途总的来说南瞻，南瞻还是南瞻，南瞻不轴，中央印度金刚座是现阶前佛成佛的地方，居所空间也不会毁灭，并且远离四大的什么损害，宛如空中线通一般，中央有菩提树装饰，以金刚座为中心的圣地，诸城市成为地界中土。所谓的佛法中土是指佛教正法所存在之地，无有佛法存在的地方称为遍地。因此以前佛出世以来到佛法存在之时，印度即是地界的中土了，也是佛法的中土。但是据说因为那是巴珠仁波切当时呢，就是的确是这个情况，现在印度金刚座已被外道所占领，就是当时作者就是巴珠仁波切在世期间呢，确实被回教所占，但如今又恢复成为佛法中土，这是说在堪布的这个是叫什么
遗嘱
呀。但这里是我自己也去过很多次嘛，因菩提迦耶嘛，现在的菩提迦耶。那菩提迦耶呢，不仅是印度回教，主要是南林陀那种烧掉的是回教的这个回教，但是印度中土呢，主要是不是那个菩提迦耶主要占领的是除了回教之外呢，都是印度教。
So in this part, it talks about the heretics, which is the word which we'll just use here. It's, thirtikas. So actually, when Khenpo went to India, and he went also to Bodhgaya. Yeah. And so where there used to be the Muslims, as well as the Hindus there.
Bodhgaya 的根据它在中间嘛，这个它的这个立面的立这个围墙的立面，这个围墙的立面都有，现在都有印度教的这个庙，但是这个还没有，现在没有开放，因为这个印度政府这种法律就是完全这个松，就是已经回到那个佛教徒的这个手上，所以现在这个就佛教徒有这个权利。所以他们没有开放，在里面没有进行，但是因为印度对宗教非常严，那种严格是就是那种非常敏感嘛，就是非常保护的，所以呢也不能拆，就是放在那边。以前呢比如说这个根据他的这个正面的旁边有一些那个印度教的那个圣的一些标志，然后这个上面呢听说要那个动物这个杀动物的那个血滴到那边的那种就是有这种意识，就是几百年一直这样下去的。20世纪的中才就开始这个就是变成佛教徒的地方恢复了。
When Buddhists left India and when the other religions such as Muslims and Hindus were there, and so they did a lot, however, so and still you see some sculptures, you can still see that when they killed animals, you can still see the blood on the statues. Now all the Muslims and Hindus, they left the area. But that is just protected, and so nothing was removed yet.
这个佛教圣地归回佛教徒的那个手上的这个过程当中呢， 最贡献最大的是斯里兰卡的一个居士叫达玛巴拉，法禅法护达玛巴拉，你就自己
去当。Okay, so, in returning, India, to the, to in reverse the India back to Buddhism, a person, a practitioner of Sri Lanka has very great contributions.
他的雕像，一个雕像在瓦拉纳西也有一个这个达玛巴拉的雕像。
This practitioner's name is
Dharmabala.
Dharmabala. Yeah, it's this practitioner. Still, you could see his sculptures, his statue actually.
Mahabuddha 是他们那个时候的 Mahabuddha Society 什么的，就是协会，那个一个，一个。反正这个，然后呢，他们也就是申请这个印度最高人民法院嘛，不是人民法院，最高法院，就是透过后来就是印度政府，就是印的这个有点诉讼那种上诉吧，就是怎么的概念我不知道，就是，六七十年前的事情了。
是他们上诉是做什么？
就是那个布迪嘎呀，要送，
要回到。
佛教，对。
Okay, so it's actually about 70 years ago, and through the Supreme Court, that Bodhigaya were turned to Buddhism. Okay.
反正啊。
就七十年哦。
差不多。
70
something like that.
And
before that, it was Hindu or?
他之前是印度还有回教，
对
，Yeah,
Hindu
and Muslim。
不是那个毁灭的这个主要的因素是回教，但是后来掌控那种
是印度教。
印度教
啊、it was destroyed, by the Muslims, but later it was taken over by the Hindus。
就是印度教，他们当作自己的教堂，就是那个庙。
so just Hindus, they just.Hinduists, they just took it for their temples.
It was originally Buddhist.
No, 原来是
那当然了，就是龙树菩萨更早的时候有的，还有那个最上面的一个层次，龙树菩萨盖的，然后后面的围墙也是龙树菩萨修的，所以这个历史非常长的。
And all this and all the walls were built by Nagarjuna.
So the Hindus took over.
Bad
karma.
比如说，就这个，这个上面的是龙树菩萨的时候，就是什么
？So that part was built in the Nagarjuna.
Nagarjuna.
这个旁边，这边就是本来有，现在你好像应该这个也是印度教的一个庙。
那是印度教的庙。
对。
And that small, very small area is a temple of Hinduism.
Oh, okay.
这个中间就是有，就是这个，这个现在。
This is in the middle.
主要的是。
No, it's in the temple.
它是那个活佛时代的菩萨吗？
不是，的确不是。但是呢，佛陀的这个，应该是夏利布。哎，不是，我现在有跟那个另外一个概念，佛陀成佛的地方。
哦，那龙树菩萨大概是什么时代的？
佛陀圆寂后的500年后的。
哦。
现在来讲，2000年前。
Okay, so Bodhigaya is the place where Buddha gets enlightened, get liberation, and but so this tower was built. about 500 years later. 这个塔是在就是，yeah，这个它的历史应该有2200多，就是比龙树菩萨还早一点点。 Okay, so this stupa is actually about 2200 years old, and so it started built a little bit earlier than Nagarjuna. So Nagarjuna just built on it.
那个有很长的故事啊。
And that is a very long story.
这个里面的这个佛像跟我们西藏的大昭寺的这个佛像啊，这个都已经也有一些关系。那个大昭寺的佛像本来是从印度就是邀请到唐代的那个中突，然后再从那边就是游移到那个吐蕃，然后当时的西藏就是这样的故事嘛。所以这个佛像哈。
So about the Buddha statues, they are more or less related with each other like sisters brothers. So like in Tibet in Jokhang Temple, the huge Buddha statue also were brought from India, 是从印度。 然后去中土大唐的这个皇宫里的可能最重要的一个，那后来呢，那个文成公就嫁给那个松村干部的时候，就是，然后就把那个大佛像带着，对，okay, so that Buddha statue was brought to the central area of China, ancient China, 是我的家乡，okay，yeah，对，是到西安的话。
Okay. Oh, right, right, right. Yeah. Xi'an.
So it was brought to Xi'an, which was the very center of Tang Dynasty China. And from there, it was brought again to Tibet, following just accompanying a marriage of a princess of that area to the king of Tibet. It's Songtan
Gampu. It's Songtan Gampu. Yeah, good. Oh yeah, 好了，所以已经无有征伐的遍地了。其实现在也在印度，大家觉得啊，佛教圣地，其实印度的总的人口来讲的话，佛教徒呢，听说是 1%。 差不多。
People might think that India is the Dharma field of nowadays, but actually, it's said that only 1% of the total population, Indian population, are Buddhist.
那个也大部分是喜马拉雅山区的那些藏传佛教最多，其他很有限。And additionally,
no. Put in other words, so even these 1% are the populations living along the hillside of Himalayas, where the Tibetans and Tibetan Buddhism were very active.
比如说，宗瑟佛学院在印度有500多个成都的喇嘛，那个里面一个真正的那个印度人，那种印度。 人中的那个印度人，当喇嘛的唯一有一个。
just like in Zhongsha, Zhongsha,
佛学院。Institute什么的，他们我们用。Institute，yeah，Zhongsha，Zhongsha Institute。可以用其他的电子。In
that very famous Institute of Buddhism, there's only one Lama out of 500 is Indian. So one out of 500 was Indian.
Nepal人跟Buddha跟就是西藏过去的就是这些。
So all the other
尼泊尔的也不是尼泊尔的宗族的那个人，也是喜马拉雅山区的，就是藏族，
也是藏族。
对，他是宗族来讲的话，算是藏族。
So among all the others, there's Nepalese, there are also Bhutanese, but mainly these people are originally from Tibet. So basically, they are also Tibetans.
所以他其实现在的佛教呢，印度就是这样吧。So
that is the situation of Buddhism in India.
但最近这个印度新总理特别重视这个佛教。But
the new prime minister of India, pay much attention to Buddhism.
但这个重视里面有政治。But
in some, for some political purpose.
不过，对佛教来讲的话呢，有些是好事。But
it still does good to Buddhism.
像前几天呢，他也就是斯里兰卡专门邀请他们的 Visak，那个御萨戒，印度总理亲自就是参加出席这个斯里兰卡的 Visak。
In past days, there's the Visak ceremony in Sri Lanka. And the new prime minister of India was invited, and he went there.
而且同时在新德里，印度文化部部长宣布，全印度的中小学的课程里面必须要有佛法课程。那是好事。And
the minister of education culture, that is based in New Delhi, and in his new policies, he said that Buddhist teaching must be included in the new curriculum in the schools.
So, they said that now, Buddhist teaching must be included in the new curriculum in the schools.
So you can see that the wisdom of Buddhism is very effective now.
这是一个新的新闻，也是好的新闻。
This is a news, and this is a good news.
Yeah.
Better than the problem.
Better than the problem.
Yeah.
那比尼泊尔好，你们现在比尼泊尔好。我这个其实说来话长。啊，是老师，对。为什么呢？因为，那，我说，这个现在尼泊尔也开始这个比较喜欢佛教，当自己就说佛陀是在我们这里出生，所以印度跟尼泊尔之间有那种。
So Nepalese also think that they begin to realize that Buddha was born in Nepal, so they thought that they must be proud of it. So they try to debate with India to say, okay, so we are actually the origin of Buddhism.
Because 就是意思是说，不是，就是意思是说，他们自己要杀生来供养鸡，鸡食，然后呢，佛教徒也，他们国土的现在就没有了，现在他们共和国就变成什么的，所以但是呢，现在他们呢，就是因为这个实际上佛教跟佛法的那种越来越殊重视的时候，因为地学是现在，那个伦比尼就是属于尼泊尔嘛，他们觉得啊，我们是佛陀的故乡。
Yeah, of course. So Nepal used to be an area of Hinduism, and so even somebody was born a Buddhist, he still has to break an egg in order to show that that they kill, because that is a conflict with the Buddhists. So, but now the Nepal the people in Nepal, they thought that they should be very proud of it because Buddha was born in Nepal, so they are the homeland of Buddha.
而且现在不大，尼泊尔的大部分的佛这个寺庙都是藏传佛教跟从西藏来的上师，还有一部分有一些南传的，一部分是就是台湾那边的啊这种来的一些部分。嗯，现在呢，就是应该是汉地来的也越来越多。就好像缅甸的、泰国在那边都开这个，那已经是。So
nowadays in Nepal, in most temples, it is actually the Buddhists that they are practicing and teaching are the Tibetan Buddhism, and the teachers and the lamas, the gurus are all from mainly from India, and also from some other like Nanchuan.
Yeah.
It's from Sri Lanka.
From Sri Lanka, Thailand.
Yeah.
那个他们为什么要去尼泊尔？是不是也是因为蓝底尼在那边，然后又是到这个，
当然是，出生的地方哈。对。所以，是吧？然后也帮助尼泊尔的比较偏僻的穷人，然后他们愿意学佛，就是也去上大学。好，next one。
所以就是这样了啊，在藏地的，你没讲完吗？OK，都太快了。你刚刚翻译
OK 了，你讲完了，OK。 在此，在此那个藏地学语在佛陀出世的时候，无有很多人类之众生，并且佛教也未得到弘扬，所以成为偏僻的藏地了。那个叫做塔克卡瓦吉。 后来，人类众生逐渐增多，出现了许多甚至化身的国王。萨托多人年赞是十七，这是国王的名字。一个叫拜什么拜比拜拜拜拜拜拜忏悔经和圣塔肖像印摩，降落到这个宫那个王宫上。 然后呢，此为这个正法的开端。根据这个当时的授记呢，再过五个朝代后，以后会有人了知，经中的含义。大别神尊化现为国王显像法王松村干部，因为西藏人非常。 非常崇拜松村干布，所以就是把他列这种奉承观慈的菩萨的化身。当时呢，国王松村干布，配奇义，是吧？一是二个这个图米三菩萨，就是一个人的名字，他也是藏文的创始者，然后前往印度学习声明文者等，声明就是文法。 的意思，结束了西藏没有文字的历史，开创了文字，并将31种观自在的经跟虚集，然后须弥生无等须弥生无就是他多多人年在时候的那个法宝，也翻译成藏文，依靠法王的众多身边集。 以及大臣噶尔东征，是很有名的一个大臣。就应该是在三国里面，是不是诸葛亮？诸葛亮是不是很有名的一个大臣？军事的军事嘛，在吐蕃的历史上，噶尔东征差不多有这个这样的地位。 所以现在民间都有很多他的传说，噶尔就是噶尔东征，噶尔。
This is about a person whose name is called Tom Tsung. He's a very important minister for the king, Songtsen Khenpo. and he was as important as Zhuge Liang, who is the top full of wisdom to the king of the three kingdom dynasty in China.
Oh yeah. 就是这样护国的方法，然后呢就是迎娶汉帝及尼泊尔的两位公主为王妃，然后汴江佛陀的代表梁尊，释迦牟尼佛像等，就许多三宝所依，殷勤到西藏，并且修建了以拉萨大昭寺为主的正。 持寺和正觉寺，当许多寺庙开创了正法。那我这里一起来说明一下几个事情。一个呢，就是，他拉图多日念赞的时候，那个来的这个佛经跟那个擦擦，就是那个摸那个法什么摸，有没有看到？刚刚那个。 江夏的擦擦，对，它其实是一种，我觉得擦擦的这个墨。那西藏的传说是从天上降到这个它的工厂，但是现在的历史学家觉得应该是那个时候有印度来往，然后印度从印度受到的一些或者尼泊尔受到的一些礼物，因为这个佛法的这个礼物，但是的确没有翻译，然后也没有佛法，所以不懂它的文字的内容是什么。 后来，崇正干波的时候，就是开始有藏文，有翻译的人才，就开始翻译成藏文。所以呢，佛教跟藏传、西藏跟佛教的缘起是从拉陀多日念僧开始，就这个意思。
这个是什么？小象印模是什么意思？
就是一个小佛像的印模啊。
一个小佛像的一个印模啊。
对。
Okay, concerning the tsa tsa mode, which refers to, so people in the old time said that it is something that's probably falling from the heaven or whatever, but actually later the historians proved, or archaeologists proved that this must be something, some gifts from India or Nepal, but in the old time there's no language in Tibet. So people had no idea what is written that there, and they just guess it's something from the heaven. And so it is from the king, Lato III, who sent translators to India and who brought the language, who introduced the alphabet into Tibet.
就是那个百拜忏悔经和这个印模一起到了王宫。对对对。就是它有一本经，百拜忏悔经。这个就它就是里面有很多的佛的，我看过，就是很多的这个佛，礼佛的方式，就是很多的。佛的方式。也不是方式，就是里面有很多的佛号，然后忏悔，就是这样一个念诵用的，就是这样。
就我们修炼的时候不有那个忏悔？
忏悔经其实是一个忏悔经。
So the question is about the Sutra of 100 Evocations and Prostrations. It is actually a prayer book.
因为其实我觉得应该是几千年前的，大概的人类都差不多，尤其是西藏呢，非常对那个天很崇拜，所以呢，有些莫名来的或者不太懂的都当做从天上下来。
这也是我们历史的一种一贯的想法嘛，客观来讲就这样解释就可以了。这个一切不要紧，就是我们可以科学跟比较就事论事来，可以调整一些观念的，这个不会影响我们的修行。到底它是不是从天上下来，这根本不重要。而且我们也可以理解当时的人的这个想法，一些历史的那种传说。现在也可以理解，现在也这样。
对，不是这个意思，现在我们可以理解，就是也是的，现在也是这样。
对对对。
OK。
不同方式奉献。
嗯。
OK，so、okay, to take the historical view that every, so human beings are similar. If we look back to 1,000 years ago, when people just worship something in a heaven. So when there's something mysterious and people will take it for granted that it is from heaven, from some mysterious God. But it's just from this point of view, so it's quite similar among all different cultures or countries.
其实呢, 一部经叫做大乘白莲花经, 就是班达日嘎, 苏达, 玛雅那, 班达日嘎, 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 苏达, 应该是你英文说班达日嘎就好, 或者白莲花, 直接翻译也可以。
It's a sutra of white lotus.
里面呢, 特别有, 观世音菩萨, 对血瘀的, 就是西藏, 血瘀的一些种种的发心。 所以根据这个说法呢，我们非常相信西藏的一些具有代表性的，像宋正干部、持诵迭尊、大力尊者，还有那个大巴法王都是观世音菩萨的化身。其实是我们也有一些根据的，因为我们觉得他们对这个地方就是，那种印象最大，然后就是我们最崇拜的那些呢，我们相信是也是观世音菩萨有关系的。
According to the White Lotus Sutra, there's the aspiration concerning the snow world or snow field, and it says that that different there are different animations of Avalokiteshvara.
No. Sure. 这个应该演这个游戏。Okay.
Okay. So including Dalai Lama, he's also the emanation of.
Gamma Ba.
Okay.
Gamma Ba, 你说。
Gamma Ba. They are all the emanation of Avalokiteshvara.
Yeah, Avalokiteshvara. OK，那第三个要说明的是，就忘记了。看一下，讲到哪里？刚刚。擦擦。哦，是，现在呢，就是我们已经结束了。大多是，哦，对，这个。 政治是跟政界事的解释，你们看这个第十二跟第十三的这个注解吧，那就可能我们今天时间的关系不讲。它其实是政，就是政府，因为我们这个当时呢，松赞干部去的那个汉地的这个文成公主，她是风水很厉害的，当时都可能是汉地风水很就是流行。 然后呢，他跟风水呢，整个呢就是有个藏地的，就是有一种有个人，妖龟啊什么的，有个什么，反正呢，他某一个地方都支，就是这个支体的那个支都要正负，然后就是要这个五个支的地方要五个，这个大的庙，然后呢界就是这个西界的那个地理的另外一些部分的位置上也要庙。 所以呢，这个叫做孝界庙，就是政界跟政治这个概念来的。然后就是，比如说现在也剩下的，比如说在不丹也有，因为不丹当时就是还是属于可能是吐蕃的吧，就是也有。现在因为不丹后来没有那种文革啊什么的吧，现在也有完整的有一，其中一座松赞干部时候的庙还在。
There are two temples mentioned on the book. One is Thadu, the other is Yangdu. These two temples, in English, it may not mean anything, but in Chinese, there were. It really means something. They really mean something. So the first one, Thadu, means that it used to be some 是恶魔是吧？嗯，OK。 So there's used to be a devil. So there needs several different temples to suppress the five limbs. And also there also the necessity for the temples to also suppress the joints of the body of the devil.
Okay.
Yeah.
Huh?到了第五朝代天子这个松赞干部不是赤松殿长的时期呢应请了三帝与轮辟就是无比的天下无比的这个密州大赤明智这都是反正斗鱼的就是不用没有特别的意思就是莲花生大师啊就是赤明智这个恶金莲花生大师等一百零八位半之大 建造了三位不变之称大殿也是西藏说法就是三位寺等圣所仪的寺庙这个所仪这个就是三宝所仪有圣所仪嘛圣所仪啊然后呢川OK嗯啊大意识弥罗赞那是寒地的这个唐 玄奘大师的地位就是藏地的翻译者当中比如咱俩是差不多跟玄奘的这个地位差不多的就是最厉害的翻译者大意识比如咱俩等一百零八位意识学习翻译了印度身体十分兴盛的所有经绪论为主的 所以啊，欲所所以，啊，御舍七人啊，就是一种，这个御舍呢，就是七人出家成立了，圣团为一所以，当时佛教十分兴盛，犹如阳光普照大地，六传至今虽然经历了一系列的兴衰。 但其实上，但实际上，如来的教法与正法从未毁灭，所以西藏是佛法兴盛的中枢了，不是地种族，但是佛法的中枢了，因为有完整的佛法。什么叫完整的佛法呢？就是有圣所仪跟义所仪跟义所仪三个所仪都具足的话，那完整的佛法。
什么三所仪是什么？地所仪、圣所仪。
身口意，身所意，身所意就是佛想跟寺庙。所意，对，就是对象嘛，就是崇拜对象嘛。身体的身嘛。身所意就是我们身体所能接触的，比如说寺庙啊这些东西，佛想啊这些是身所意。意所啊，还有口所意是吧？意就是寓言的意，口也可以了。意所意呢，就是这个佛法的经典，经论。意所意呢，就是收接啊，就是你看出家的那种有出家人啊，真正的修行人的地方就是。对对对对对对，OK。
So Tibet is actually the central country or the central field of Dharma practice, in the sense that it has the opportunity, it is equipped with the complete Dharma. By complete Dharma, we mean that there's the uphold of body, and the upholder of speech, as well as the upholder of mind. So that means there are temples and Buddha statues, there are Dharma, and there are Sanghas.
Yeah. 这个概念很重要，比如说我们现在这边呢，我们也要寓所于跟修行的一些我们的那个的，我们也其实为什么我们没有重心啊，实际上也是要讲经说法，有一些困难。很具体来说，没有真正的一个自己地方，有时候，当然我们现在呢就是这样轮流啊，大家那边就是提供一些地方，可是以西藏来讲。 以印度来讲的话呢，这种是很艰难的一种，也是一个事情。所以呢，这是一种这里呢，就是具不具足这个佛法呢？那当然有些是具足，有些是还是有一些有限的一个条件，对吧？所以呢，这里呢特别强调说，但是如果有寺院，也没有佛法是没有有的，所以呢，只有神所依也不够的，很禁闭绘画的一个地方。 也没有讲经说法是不行，所以一所依，那一所依也不修行就不行啊，所以要一所依，所以神与义都有了，所以西藏是佛教的圣地，这个说法是就是任何地方都我们可以接受，那里有没有真正的佛法，就看有没有这三个都有没有。Okay,
if we look at our Dharma learning. We do not have a center, and this is a real a situation which is a little bit difficult for us. The good thing is that that people take turns to provide us the places of Dharma teaching.
Unfortunately, we have to go.
And so people like when they provide us a place which functions as a place where we could just do the Dharma teaching, Dharma learning. It's just functions as a temple. But even if there is temple, but can we say that is enough? If there is no Dharma, then that is not enough. If there is Dharma and temple, are they enough for the to become a Dharma field? And not necessarily, because at least we still need the Sangha to guide our practice. So only when these three come together, there is the Dharma.
Yeah. 所以呢, 根什么根的圆满呢？如果无根，这种任何一根不具足，也不能成为出家受戒持戒的发起。但这个要强调是圆满，最圆满的不是，但是还是可以受了。啊，并且因为无有勤止、勤俭什么恭俭对金所以如来的神像等，或者阅读听闻思维的对金。 鉴定如意宝的缘分，所以不能称为真实的法器。这里真实就是不是最好的意思，有一些下层。一乐的圆满呢，所谓的业绩得到，是指生于猎人、妓女等的中性，从小就屈入了业绩得到之道。 但实际上是三门所做的未必真相的未必那叫什么未必正法的行为都属于业绩得到，所以虽然我们起初呢没有生于这样的中心，但也未来很容易变成业绩得到的人。 因此，必须勤，是自相续，不未必正法。心性圆满呢？如果对心性的对境佛法不起信心，而对其他的事情大力 天龙灯或者外道教派无论升起怎么样的信心，也不能从轮回和恶趣的痛苦中解脱出来。所以正是了者如来的教法和真法的道理，并因此升起坚定不移信心的真行者，才是真正无谬的法器，此为五种真圆门的根本。就我们就今天讲到这里了啊，但是还有七分钟可以吗？我们是不是对？所以有没有问题可以问？你问。
This is the place where we start teaching, but any questions?
刚才您说那个三恶趣，天人旁生还有一个恶趣是
不是？恶鬼。
哦，恶鬼。
对。
那和地狱旁生恶鬼是一回事吗？
这就是三种，旁生是一般的动物嘛。
动物
之类的，对，人之外的，我们看到的那些所有动物都是算是旁生。那恶鬼是另外一个中心，地狱是另外一个更惨的那种地狱，就是一个六道当中的其中一个道。
六
道众生。
六道就是六道轮回。
对对对。
哦。
So you know that?
那个一乐圆满和信心圆满，就是大概。怎么就是我总觉得他俩有点像
啊。没有错啊。你说那个嘛。
意乐圆满和信心圆满。
OK。你们就跟我做领导嘛，我们也就跟我做领导嘛，我们对呀，就是说，一乐圆满呢，他的态度不是很恶劣的，极恶劣的，就是他那种不挑顺的，比如说他就是完全是一个猎人，他信不信佛法还没有关系，只是他的那种心相许是完全是一种，相为佛法的一个缘分的障碍在。所以这个意乐不圆满的。第二个呢，如果他是正常人，很好的人，非常好的一个人，我们不是有一半人当中也有人吗？他没有信仰的，但是他绝对不愿意学佛法的话，就是第五个条件上的障碍。虽然是不是妓女，也不是屠夫，也不是，就是很正常的一个人，而且很有善意的那种人，但是也他不学佛，就是说，就是信心圆满就没有。现在有差别吗？
In terms of advantages intention, it means that if somebody was born a hunter or somebody became prostitutes at early age, so they do not, so in this sense, they do not have the good intention to do the Dharma. But if it is the advantage, concerning the advantage of faith, probably the person is quite a good person, he's notHe's not hunter, he's not prostitute, but he just, he does not have faith in Dharma. He probably take other gods or other beliefs as a faith, or he has no faith at all. So in that sense, he does not have the advantage of faith in Dharma. That is the difference.
Other question?
对，刚才您提到那个龙树菩萨，
yep.
我在很多书上看到这个名字。那可以就是简单的说一下，从那个就是佛陀到龙树菩萨这五百年之间发生了什么事吗？或者有什么重要的事情
？500 years between the birth of Buddha and later when Nagarjuna.
其实可以这么，你的问题很好，也可以用发生这个字来问。在这五百年当中发生了很多事情。譬如说佛陀圆寂之后的三个劫机，知道吗？劫机。劫机就是结束的结，结束了，这什么什么事情结束的结。 鸡就是鸡通的鸡，结集。
结集。
进殿的结集。
就是一堆僧人在一起集结，结集。
它是结集吧，应该是。
叫结集。
对，结集。
就团结的结。集集团，
集
体的集。
团结的结吗？
结集。
哦，是吧？我不知道啊。什么戒啊？这个，因为就是第一个戒。
就结集，什么？
啊，团结的结一样，
就是团结的结，梵文。
对。对。达尔玛什么？
梵文是 Samgati。
你看这里有，这个结集叫做 Samgati。
Samgati。
这是非常重要的，就是佛陀呢，其实意思是说，一起用大型的开会，具有代表性的、全国性的人大的代表一起来，然后进行一个整理佛陀的这个演讲。这个叫做结集。然后第一阶级、二阶级、三阶级都是佛陀涅槃到龙树菩萨还没有出来之前发生的，这是佛教历史上的大发生嘛，也不少的吧。就还有第二阶级跟三阶级当中呢，也发生了不好的事。佛教分为十八个派系，印度的十八部，然后互相有很大的一个争议，然后呢，后来慢慢就是已经和解了。然后这个过程都在这个里面发生的，所以这都很有趣的。
那那个龙树菩萨他
那个翻译一下，对，他翻译他一下。
Okay, so actually, what happened in this 500 years? The most notable one is called a three
Sangiti.
Actually, it refers to three assemblies. So the first assembly is, it's between the Buddha's birth to Nagarjuna, and so the masters and the sanghas from all over the country was assembled together to talk about, to discuss and to learn the Buddha's teaching. And that is the first assembly. The first Sangiti, and the second and third Sangiti. During the second and third Sangiti, the Buddhism was divided into 18 different branches, and they conflict with each other. But finally, they get reunified.
Yeah. 那你说，你继续说刚刚龙叔的。
我的意思就是说，那那个龙树菩萨他在这个时间，就是跟2000年前他做了一些什么主要的事情呢？就是有什么
非常好。第一呢，他当了南林陀的那种主要的负责人，然后呢，他也
数百年以后，第三次集结以后，
对，
就2000年前，
对，就他出生到那个圆寂之间呢，他呢就是。大乘佛教在人间那个时候没有很兴盛，因为龙树菩萨开始大乘佛教就很兴盛了。这个方面就是龙树菩萨，还有龙树菩萨的弟子跟他的这个僧团里面，就是十八部的通通都有。而且他以他的诸师就是诸阶，里面有初转法轮、二转法轮、三转法轮，就是佛陀整个法轮的解释都有。所以他的贡献非常大。而且他也是非常伟大的哲学家，就是现在也是世界上也有他的这个，对，哲学历史上也他就是因为他的纵观的那个解释就。
So the second question is about Nagarjuna.
是。
So he's actually the most contributive to the.Promotion of Mahayana.
最近有翻译。
And also, he did a lot of interpretation concerning the Buddha's teaching. and also he did a lot of interpretation and notes concerning the three tenets of the Dharma wheels. So, and also he's the very great, one of the greatest philosophers.
Oh, 谢谢大家的提问。
Thank you for the questions.
我们就现在回想了啊。
So we do the meditation.
宋能的也不是宋能的也当家是观念同的也别沾难感谢将谢干那只我乱出发也四面做了人若若若若以此功德也成佛自己
相佛烦恼远离之过往生来便是拥有之过他愿度众生皆多轮回海
By this memory, may all sense be attentive, defeated the enemy of all thoughts, and restore the only grace of our earth's aging sweetness and death. May I
liberate
all beings from the ocean of samsara.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.